गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आर यू एबल टू हियर माय वॉइस? हेलो
हेलो, कैन यू हियर मी?
Can you hear me?
Yes,
sir. Okay. Just give me 2 more minutes. I am taking the session from school. So few settings I need to do. ओके, एक काम करते हैं, लेट मी शेयर विथ यू माय स्क्रीन एज वेल. आई नीड टू इंस्टॉल वन सॉफ्टवेयर, सो यू लर्न समथिंग. अच्छा, बाय द वे, यस्टरडे आई स्टार्टेड वॉचिंग अ मूवी, हर्षद मेहता स्कीम, 1992, एंड इट वॉज रियली अ ग्रेट मूवी. बहुत मज़ा आई, बट मुझे पता नहीं चला इतनी लंबी ये मूवी है या सीरियल है. व्हाट इज दिस?
सर, सीरीज है, सीरीज अलग अलग एपिसोड है.
ओके, सो कहाँ ये टेलीकास्ट कर रहे हैं?
सोनी लिव.
ओके, सो टेलीविजन पर आता है?
नहीं सर, ये लोग ओटीटी पे, मतलब ये मूवीज आती है ना.
ओके, सो ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म में ये देख सकते हैं. गुड. ओके, सो वन मोर थिंग आई केम टू नो अबाउट शकुंतला देवी और समथिंग लाइक दैट, कि शी वाज एन इंडियन मैथमेटिशियन एंड विद्या बालन हैज प्लेड अ वेरी ग्रेट रोल एंड शी हैज डन सुपर्ब एक्टिंग. आई हैव नॉट येट सीन, बट इफ यू हैव द लिंक देन यू कैन शेयर विद मी. अच्छा, हर्ष टिल नाउ I have not checked the papers, but give me 1 or 2 days time. Surely I will let you know the marks as soon as possible. Test 4 के marks आज ही आपको बता दूंगा. किसी ने देखी है वो movie?
Yes sir.
Okay, so how is it?
सर, आप किसकी बात कर रहे हो?
इट इज गुड.
ये कुछ शकुंतला देवी करके कोई मूवी है?
हाँ सर, हाँ हाँ, देखी.
सो इफ यू हैव एनी लिंक तो यू कैन शेयर विथ मी.
सर वो Amazon Prime पे है.
अच्छा.
हाँ सर, उसको लिंक के साथ शेयर नहीं कर सकते.
ओके, सो आई हैव प्राइम मेंबरशिप, मैं कभी गया नहीं हूँ, सो दैट्स गुड. I will start using that. So just 1 minute more. Actually, today there is a meeting in school and I am supposed to report it 12:15. So I need to take the session from school. So I need to change so many things. आर यू एबल टू सी ऑन योर स्क्रीन अबाउट दिस अनलॉक की एंड लाइसेंस नंबर?
यस सर.
ओके. Okay, so here we need to start with another method of depreciation. It's called written down value method. So please start writing what you are able to see on your screen. Now, name of the method is written down value method. Written down value means WDV method. Another name is reducing balance method. Already aap sabko pata hai, it is also denoted as RBM. In place of reducing, you can also use the word diminishing. So, diminishing value method can also be suggested. Now, as per Income Tax Act, this method is acceptable. WDV method is acceptable. Straight line method income tax में नहीं चलता है. So income tax act में rate of depreciation is different. Now कुछ practical बात करता हूँ. Okay, लोगों को CA की जरूरत क्यों पड़ती है? मैं पहले depreciation की बात करता हूँ. तो first of all, ये जो depreciation है, लेट्स से देर इज ए कंपनी, तो कंपनी को कंट्रोल करने वाले दो मेजर एक्ट्स है. एक एक का नाम है कंपनीज एक्ट, ओके, 2013 में ये रिवाइज हुआ था, कंपनीज एक्ट. सो एज पर कंपनीज एक्ट, फाइनेंशियल बुक्स प्रिपेयर किए जाते हैं. And as per Companies Act, you get net profit. Okay? And there is another act is called Income Tax Act. Now this Income Tax Act kehta hai ke we need books in such a way that it is prepared as per our rules and regulations. So Income Tax Act mein depreciation alag way se calculate hota hai, and Companies Act mein depreciation alag way se calculate hota hai. To mujhe bataiye ke dono jo profits honge wo same honge ya different honge? Profit as per Companies Act or profit as per Income Tax Act? This would be different because depreciation hi different hai. And apart from depreciation also, alag alag jagah par different different treatment hai. So normally jo hum right now accounting seekh rahe hai, it is as per the Companies Act. But why people need the services of a professional? Because in Companies Act itself is a very vast thing. Businessman ko business karne ka time bhi nahi hota hai. To about compliance, उसे प्रोफेशनल्स की जरूरत पड़ती है। एंड इनकम टैक्स एक्ट के भी रूल्स बहुत ही कॉम्प्लेक्स होते हैं। सो रिकंसिलेशन बिटवीन द प्रॉफिट्स एज पर फाइनेंशियल बुक्स एंड टैक्सेशन बुक्स इज रिक्वायर्ड एंड डेप्रिसिएशन इज वन सच आइटम वेयर अकाउंटिंग ट्रीटमेंट इज डिफरेंट, कैलकुलेशन इज डिफरेंट। एज पर कंपनी से डिफरेंट कैलकुलेशन है, एज पर इनकम टैक्स एक्ट डिफरेंट कैलकुलेशन है। तो प्लीज नोट, एज पर इनकम टैक्स एक्ट रिटन डाउन वैल्यू मेथड इज एक्सेप्टेबल, नॉट द स्ट्रेट लाइन मेथड। नाउ कमिंग बैक टू मेन पॉइंट, यहाँ पर डेप्रिसिएशन किस तरह से कैलकुलेट होता है। लेट्स से वन एग्जाम्पल, क्वेश्चन इज लाइक दिस, कैलकुलेट रिटन डाउन वैल्यू ऑफ अ मशीन बॉट ऑन 1st April 2018 फॉर 10,000 आफ्टर 2 years, okay? So, solution, how to do this calculation? So, first of all, I will write original cost on 1/4/18, which is 10,000, and we will minus depreciation. Let's say, take depreciation at 10%, which is given in the question. So depreciation 10% in the first year will be calculated on this 10,000, so it will be 1,000. So you will get written down value after depreciation in the next years. So it in the starting of second year, what will be your written down value? $9,000. Now again I will charge depreciation for the second year at 10%. So can you please tell what should be the depreciation and on which amount it should be calculated?
900.
Perfect. So here, written down value, it means the value after depreciation will go on decreasing each year. Har saal. रिटर्न डाउन वैल्यू कम होती रहेगी एंड एज ए रिजल्ट यू कैन सी दैट कि डेप्रिसिएशन भी एवरी ईयर धीरे धीरे रिड्यूस होता रहेगा। ओके, सो इन दिस मेथड एक स्टेटमेंट जनरली लोग कहते हैं कि वैल्यू ऑफ द एसेट विल नेवर बिकम जीरो, यानी कितना भी डेप्रिसिएशन लगा लो वैल्यू कैन नेवर बिकम जीरो। हाँ, 0.5, 0.8 ऐसी वैल्यू हो सकती है, बट एग्जिट जीरो नहीं आ सकता, बिकॉज वैल्यू इज गेटिंग रिड्यूस्ड एंड ऑन दिस रिड्यूस्ड वैल्यू यू आर चार्जिंग डेप्रिसिएशन। सो आई होप दिस कंसेप्ट इज क्लियर टू यू अबाउट रिटन डाउन वैल्यू मेथड। एंड नाउ लेट अस फोकस ऑन अ प्रैक्टिकल क्वेश्चन। सो ऑन योर स्क्रीन यू मस्ट बी एबल टू सी द क्वेश्चन एंड we need to solve the questions of written down value method. Here we have written down value method. Okay, so let us focus on this basic question. कि अ बॉयलर वाज परचेस्ड फ्रॉम अब्रॉड फॉर 10,000, शिपिंग एंड फॉरवर्डिंग चार्जेस 2,000, इम्पोर्ट ड्यूटी 7,000 एंड एक्सपेंसेस ऑफ इंस्टॉलेशन 1,000. तो बॉयलर को परचेज करने के लिए यू नो कस्टम से यू नीड टू पे एंड क्लियरिंग एंड फॉरवर्डिंग चार्जेस होते हैं, तो दिस इज टू बी एडेड टू द कॉस्ट. ये आपने पे किया तब जाके एसेट आपके फैक्ट्री पे आया. तो एड दिस 2,000, एड दिस 7,000 इम्पोर्ट ड्यूटी. इम्पोर्ट ड्यूटी इज द टैक्स विच यू पे टू द गवर्नमेंट वेन यू इम्पोर्ट फ्रॉम फॉरेन कंट्री. So it will increase the cost of asset. So add this 2,000, add this 7,000 as well as installation 1,000. So total cost kya hoga boiler ka?
20,000.
Perfect. And it says that calculate the depreciation for the first 3 years separately for each year at 10% per annum on diminishing balance method. So easily we can do this calculation. So let's do this. So here they are not asking us to prepare any boiler account. So just like this we can do the calculation. Aap bhi kar sakte hain calculation. So let's have the solution. So I will write original cost on, let's see which is the date. Achha, date is not given, so we assume we must have purchased on the first date of the year. So on 1st of April, let's say 2018. Now this date is just for your reference. Okay, abhi date ki zarurat nahi hai. And here we should show the working as well. 10,000 plus 2,000 forwarding plus 7,000 import duty plus 1,000 installation. So total is 20,000 minus 10% depreciation for this year, for 2018-19. So this 10% will be on this 2,000. So it will be 20,000. So it will be 2,000. So you will get value of 18,000. Ye kya ho jayega? Written down value on which date? In the start of next year, which will be 1920, and it will start from 1st April 2019. Ab isme se 10% depreciation we will minus for the next year, which is 1920. So it will be calculated on this 18,000. 18,000 ka 10% will be 1,800. So we will get written down value for the next year, which is 2021. It will start from 1st April 2020. How much it will be?
16,200.
Perfect. Again, we will minus 10% depreciation for next year, which is 2021. It will be calculated on 16,200. Just ignore the last zero. So we'll get 1,620. And when you minus, finally, you will get written down value after the end of 3 years. So it will be on 1st April 2021.
4,580.
Sorry, repeat.
14,580.
14,580. Now, look here. Question may it was asked, calculate the depreciation for the 3 years on diminishing balance method. So we have calculated depreciation. So it was 2,000, 1,800 and 1,620. And balance after for cross-checking. After 3 years, balance means written down value of asset, and it should be 14,500, which we are able to get here. So this concept is very easy. So only difference between straight line method and written down value method is this. In straight line method, always we charge depreciation on the original costs. But in case of written down value method, there is a slight change in the method of calculation. Now, let's see if such another small question is there, then we can. Yes. The original cost of furniture, question number 18, amounted to 4,000, and it is decided to write off 5% on the original cost as depreciation at the end of each year. Show ledger account. This is the requirement. Show ledger account, as it will appear during the first 4 years. 4 saal ka ledger account hame banana hai. Show the same how the same amount will appear if it was decided to write off 5% on diminishing balance of the asset each year. Now basically look here, initially they said 5% on the original cost. So in this question they are asking asset account as per 2 methods. First is the original cost method, जो आपको homework में दे रहा हूँ, because you already know. And second में you need to prepare ledger account. If we charge depreciation as per diminishing balance method, so we are doing part B. Second part करेंगे diminishing balance method. Original cost method already you know how to do this. So let's prepare the account. Today actually I'm taking from different PCs, so you know it becomes a bit difficult to work in a new situation, but still I hope your screen size is proper, you are able to see my ledger account properly.
Yes sir.
Okay. So in the books of the company, furniture is the asset, so we need to prepare furniture account. For year ending, okay, dates are not given, so no need. Year ending so and so. So on the first date you will write on the debit side to cash account you are buying furniture, and original cost is 4,000. So in the year end you will charge depreciation by depreciation account. Now it is 5%. So ye 4,000 ka 5%. How much it will be?
200.
Last zero ignore karo, 10% milega, which is 400, uska half kar do. And you will have to close this. So by balance, carry it down. So it will become 3,800. So over furniture account will look like this. And this 3,800 is the opening balance for the next year. So we'll write two balance brought down. Again, we will charge depreciation. But yahan par depreciation will be on this written down value. This is WDV 3,800. Jo opening value hai, opening value is written down value. So 380 ka half kar do. Kitna ho jayega?
190.
So again, I will have closing balance. So kitna ho jayega?
3,610.
Very good. So again, we will close this. Bas yahi karna hai. This is how your furniture account will look. So again, in the third year, two balance brought down. It is 3,610. Again, we'll charge depreciation, but now it will be on this portion. So 361 ka half karna hoga. Kitna hoga? Point mein ja sakta hai. So ek kaam karo, point ko ignore kar do. Okay, 361 hai, uska half karna hai. So 360 ka half kar do. So how much will it be? 180, yes or no? And we will find closing balance. So, kya iska answer point mein diya hai inhone? To fir point mein kar lete hain. Aur yahan par aapko final answer mil jayega. Again, charge depreciation for the fourth year. And this will be your final answer. So check karo. Finally, are you able to get this value or not? 3,258. Kalp ne pucha hai, why you minus 10 depreciation? Kalp paisa nahi hai, 10 rupees nahi hai. Actually, depreciation is calculated on this amount, written down value. And written down value is changing. You can see here, dekho, 4,000, then depreciation was on this 4,000. So 4,000 ka 5%. So it will be 200. Then value go down 3,800. Ab iska mujhe 5% lena hoga. So it came to 190. So gradually there is reduction in the depreciation. Lekin yaha exit 180 nahi hai. Ye kuch point mein aayega. But you know, right now, point ki details mein calculation hame nahi karna hai. For example, agar ye hai 3,610, so 10% is 3,61. So 3,61 ka half karna hai. So 3,60 ka half kitna hoga? 180. So ye 180.5 hoga, but theek hai, 0.5 you can ignore. So ye jo minus ho ra hai, wo hamesha aise same mein nahi hoga. Every time exit 10 rupees ka difference nahi hoga, but haan, difference will be near to 10. 10 ke aaspaas ka difference hoga, but comparatively, you know, this difference will be different. Uska exit amount same nahi hoga. Okay, so I hope you are clear about the basics and we'll continue tomorrow. Okay, students are able to get the answer. And anyway, this was just about understanding the basics of this method. Tomorrow we will start with the main fundamental questions where purchase and sales both are involved and more than one asset is there. So those type of questions will come in examination. Okay, bye bye. Be happy and enjoy your life.